What's up guys, welcome back for another Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Duel video. First match, Cross Balance Cup 2019. First of all, thanks for all the suggestions from previous videos. The changes to deck lists are being made. The first matchup here today, Group A, two Titans, right? Cosmos versus Pendulum Magicians. As you see, the first list here with Pendulum Magicians, I changed it. I had the first place on the World Championship qualifier from Korea back in 2017, but that tournament was played under Master Rule 3, and I wasn't really too keen on that particular list. So I decided to swap it out because a lot of people suggested that I should pick Jeff Jones' list, and I did, since that was leaning. If you ask me to which cards are in Pendulum Magician, and I directly say, of course, triple Joker, triple Iris Magician, like those cards, and those cards are here in Chef's build, so I took that one. The second list changed it since I made a mistake in the deck presentation video of Cosmos. Marvin Weber's list from back in a couple of years ago, YCS Prague, second place. Deck list speaks for itself, right? So which deck has the advantage? Seems a bit iffy, but I'm leaning a little bit towards Pendulum Magicians, even though, well, Cosmos, Solemn Brigade, Call of the Haunted, triple Dark Destroyer, triple Reasoning, triple Emergency Teleport. The deck is insane, right? But then I look at Pendulum Magicians, and we are playing with Pendulum Magicians in Master Rule 3, and, you know, that's when the pendulum mechanic was actually super, super broken, right? I mean, I'm playing pendulums and it felt super awkward. I mean, it's like, and you see it here, is that the pendulum skills are, not part of the regular spell and trap card. So, and I was like, oh, right. It just feels so, so strange that, and at the same time, that if you use your pendulum summon, you can just spam all of your extra deck monsters to the field. It's just, it feels so strange, right? After all those years, or a couple of years, into Master Rule 4. I think I had going first is of course very strong, and it was very clear for me that the trap card here, your, your Pendulum Graph trap card, should be one of your MVPs, especially holding off your opponent, but especially popping their back rows as well, and especially because of the Solemn Brigade on the Cosmo list, or at least in the Cosmo list, the Pendulum Graph trap card should be a very important key card for, like, a win, for Pendulum Magicians. Estograph Sorcerer, only a 2-off here in the deck, but you know, triple Wavering Ice and Wavering Ice, at least 3 Wavering Ice in Master Rule 3 is just ridiculous, right? Especially with Joker also at 3 here in this list. I mean, Wavering Ice, let's say you destroy your Iris Magician, Iris Magician searches any Pendulum Graph spell or trap, and after that, like, drop an Estograph Sorcerer, you just search off of Wavering Ice, get a search. It's so, so insane if you think about it. Anyway, so going second this time indeed, game number 2 if I'm not mistaken, yep, game number 2. So immediately Ash Blossom, Ash Blossom the first thing can, but he does have a follow-up play with Cosmo Dark Destroyer, so he can make his Oasis or Call of the Haunted back row live, and I think I have to force out the tin can here. In tin can, since we know he does have the Slip Rider in his hand to potentially destroy, like, the Pendulum Graph spell, but eventually, long story short, he kept that sneaky Solemn Strike. I mean, you should keep it, right, especially for the Pendulum Summon, but yeah, using the Solemn Strike on the Utopia definitely was also very good, I guess. I mean, Utopia is such a crucial card as well against Cosmos, prevents them from getting the Surge when destroyed. Another Solemn Strike. Ah, that card is so good against Pendulums. Just make sure that if you your opponent has multiple sets or one set, you go for the Pendulum, so make sure you have the Black Fang, right? This was super, super clutch. Going for Abyss Dweller, using the Pendulum Graph Trap. I believe the Pendulum Graph Trap destroying the Call of the Haunted, that of course chain Abyss Dweller, so now Dark Destroyer won't trigger. And of course, what is it called? You know which one I mean. The poison. Violet Poison Magician. Also popping the Slip Rider. So nope, no searches. Thanks to Mr. MVP, Sir Abyss Dweller. And let's not forget MVP Pendulum Graph, the trap card as well. Gets me back in this duel. And a sneaky win, but I think a well-deserved win. So game number 3, since as you know, it's of course a best out of 5. Going second again. Double reasoning, but those reasoning plays aren't that, or at least don't feel that strong. Then again, a token, some extra beat 6 on board. Well, I guess it's fine. 2 back rows, those can be like Call of the Haunted, although it's not live, I think, but I should fear like a Solemn Strike or a Warning. The trap is fine. The name escapes me. You know what I mean? The trap that banishes something. I can't remember, you know which one I mean, right? But anyway, so I can follow it up here with, you know, even though he was able to interrupt my plays with you Wavering Eyes as well, and just drop the Astrograph Sorcerer and Utopia as well, it felt okay, especially with his Eclipser not being able to attack over the life, Utopia Beyond, but nope, that's how Cosmos is, ladies and gentlemen, having the board wipe, followed up with Farm Girl is able to get that direct damage, searching like a Dark Destroyer, especially when Dark Destroyer was at 3. Still of Destruct, getting more beat sticks on the field, and that's most of the time game over. So 2-1, game number 4. I start off, and this opening, I mean, this is, well, I can't say it's nostalgic, but it's so ridiculous. I mean, it feels nostalgic. The fact that this deck has access to, first of all, a huge Pendulum Summon, Master Rule 3. Second, Iris Magician, again, not once per turn, searches, as in search your Pendulum Graph spell and a trap. And on top of that, potentially ending with, you know, multiple exceeds, multiple, synchros are one synchro, since you know the only tuner here, good tuner, level 4 tuner is of course your regular Pendulum Magician, right? It's your level 4, right? So no other tuners here. But anyway, going for a Venom, I mean, the good old times, currently banned for, you know, Electromite, etc. But back then, basically, an extra Beatstick can, at least has the potential to do some trample damage, but basically, you know, just give you the potential extra space for the Pendulum Summon. Going for Ignister, again, one of those MVP cards, the advantages that Pendulum Magicians have over Cosmos. Ignister, you know, not targeting your Cosmo, or at least the opponent's Cosmo Beatstick. So I think we have a well-deserved winner here in the long run. I mean, the Pendulum Mechanic Master Rule 3 is just so ridiculous, right? What were they thinking when they created the Pendulum Mechanic, at least in Master Rule 3? They kind of balanced it in Master Rule 4 and the Link format, but still, you know, like Electromite shenanigans. But again, well-deserved winner here. Pendulum Magicians, 3 wins, so taking up 3 points. And Cosmos, only 1 win. But yeah, let's not forget, I mean, if you look at the deck list here, Dark Matter Dragon, Death Return, Dark Armed Return, and the other decks globally here in the whole Cross Balanced Cup, it's just an insane stacked group, or an insane stacked series this year. So as previous edition, or at least as a previous edition, some extra, at least one extra duel here. This time, again, just to prevent spoilers for people not able to see when the match is going to end, just by, you know, seeing the time of the video or the length of the video. I'm not really sure. I think the opponent started off, I think so, right? Yeah, it should be. But yeah, anyway, I think this was an okay play. I mean, I think we could have expected either Oasis or Call of the Haunted, right? So I think I just had to sacrifice my Pendulum Magician here as a scale to be tributed or be destroyed by the Pendulum Graph trap card. The Joker normal summon is definitely solid, searching the, what is it called, Wisdom Eye Magician, the names. I think it's Wisdom Eye. You know, since again, top decking, if I top deck any of my Pendulum Magicians, I can't set up my scale. He does top deck into the Emergency Teleport, but that's fine, since his Tin Can is always going to get banished during the end phase if he's not tributing it, so kind of forcing him to already put up like the Forerunner, the Dark Destroyer, or the Slip Rider here on his side of the field. And again, Ignister, very easily get Ignister on the field to get rid of the, you know, the Cosmo Monster, prevented from being targeted, right? But Ignister doesn't care. So the extra duel again. I think we have a well-deserved winner here with Pendulum Magician. So like always, feel free to leave your prediction. There should be a poll somewhere here in the video. You know, just feel free. The next matchup should be Dark Matter Heretics from 2015 paired up against Dark Armed Dragon. Return that from the good old ages back in 2008. Okay, that should be it, guys. Like always, thanks again for the feedback and stay tuned for the next match. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video. Lead him signing out. Peace.